Thanks for staying with us at STL Live. I'm Sarah Thompson, and my guest is Avis McHugh of Habitat for Humanity St. Louis. And we're focusing today talking really about the home ownership program and efforts that and work that Habitat for Humanity St. Louis does. And in the first segment, we were talking about the neighborhoods. You were talking about just going into different neighborhoods, but are people familiar with the neighborhoods that you're actually currently in or have done homes in? And so could you tell us a bit more about that?
Yes. So we have actually built all over the St. Louis city and county area. So our affiliate focuses on the St. Louis metropolitan area.
Okay.
So in the past, we've done Walnut Park, Mark Twain, Hamilton Heights, Jeff Vanderloo, Florissant, Blackjack, Creve Coeur. Currently, we are building in Hazelwood. We are building in North St. Louis City, right at Riverview and 270. And we are building in South City. And then this coming spring, we will do more work in the Tiffany area, which is near St. Louis University Hospital. And then we will continue to be in Hazelwood and further south. So depending on the area that you want to go into in the school district, a lot of times is what applicants look at if they have children. Then we cover a wide range of the St. Louis area.
So both city and county, and that's what you've just described. That covers a lot of of ground. What about the application process? So somebody who's hearing this, or they know someone who really is interested in being part of the home ownership going through the home ownership process, what's the eligibility? What's the application process like?
So there is, I believe, a brochure that kind of talks about the criteria. We are looking not the same as a conventional loan, but we look at their credit, we look at income, ability to pay, and then the desire to build. A lot of times applicants will turn themselves down because they feel like they have credit issues. And one of the things that I stress more than anything is if you never apply, then you already are guaranteed that the answer is no. If you have any credit issues, then we actually have programs in place to assist with that. So each of our applicants are put into tiers. Tier one meaning that their application goes through and they are ready to go to a bank right away. Tier two means that they have some credit issues that they need to work on. Habitat actually has credit coach teams that will work with each applicant individually to focus on whatever is going on with their credit to help them get to the point where they are what we call bankable. So you do not have to come to us in perfect condition as you would necessarily have to do if you went to a bank. So all are welcome. Let us tell you what needs to happen and let's kind of partner and be a team on helping to get the keys.
Over the years, what have you found that families who move into their homes, what it was like for them to actually be a part literally of like building their, building their home? What do they say?
I think it probably is very hard to describe, but we laugh about it all the time. So we have some applicants that stalk the construction site as it's in process because they already feel ownership to the piece of land that's there or the foundation that's there. They're excited that now they have a doorbell. So once they get in, then a lot of times they don't want to put anything on the wall. The kids can't touch the walls. Like they don't want to touch this perfect thing that they have created. The big part of it is that it allows our families to understand what's happening with their house, the house itself and behind the wall. So if something goes wrong, they may not necessarily be able to fix it, but they know what's happening. So the ownership is solid. And most of the time when you move into a Habitat house, you don't move out because you put blood, sweat, and tears into it. So it's not just signing papers, but it becomes their baby.
And as you say, the sweat equity. You have two events coming up that I want to make sure we quickly get in there. One is taking place this weekend, right?
This weekend. So we have started a college prep program. We've been doing it now for about 10 years where we work with all of our middle and high school students, help them prepare for college. So we will have a scholarship program for all of our high school students. It's this Saturday. Starts at 8 o'clock. We're doing that in partnership with Student Support Center, and then we'll come back and talk later about the other event with Still Some Good in the Hood with the sporting event and community cleanup.
Okay, because that's taking place in the summer.
This summer, yes.
Okay, all right. Well, thank you so much for being here and explaining sort of the whole process. And if you want more information, you can head to the website for Habitat for Humanity. It's habitatstl.org. Go there, you can click on, there's a drop down, it says home ownership, and it kind of goes through everything that we've talked about today and much more, of course, with all the details if you're interested in applying and learning more about the program. And again, it's habitatstl.org. Well, don't go anywhere, we're going to have a quick break, but there's more STL Live right after this. Please stay with us.